Here we're asked to rationalize this fraction. So before I do this, I like to work with the prime factorizations of the coefficients. So let me rewrite 25 as 5 squared. And then we're going to multiply by what we need to get all those powers up to the index, which is 5 in this case. So multiplying by the fifth root of 5 to the third, I already have 2, so I need 3 more, a squared, b to the third, and since there's only one c, I need c to the fourth. Okay, whatever you multiply the denominator by, you have to multiply the numerator by the exact same thing. Okay, let's see what we get. In the numerator, I'm left with 15a times the fifth root. Well, 5 to the third is 125. A squared. Okay, and then I have a b to the third times a b to the third is b to the sixth. All right, and then a c to the fourth. All over. In the denominator, watch the magic. So fifth root, 5 to the third, that's 5 squared times 5 to the third. Sorry. 5 squared times 5 to the third is 5 to the fifth. That's what we want, right? A to the third times a squared is a to the fifth. B squared times b to the third is b to the fifth. All right, and this should be no surprise. All the powers in the denominator are fifth power, this perfect fifth root. Okay, so in the denominator then we can simplify this as 5abc, right? The fifth root of a is a to the fifth is a, the fifth root of b to the fifth is b, and so on. No more radical in the denominator. Okay, but I do notice in the numerator I can simplify a little bit. Here I have b to the sixth. So the fifth root, 5 goes in that 6 one time, I can pull a b out. That'll leave me with 15ab times the fifth root, that 125, a squared. Now there's going to be one b remainder, c to the fourth. Okay, we've actually rationalized it. At this point, we just need to simplify. So it looks like an a can cancel, the b will cancel, and 5 goes into that 15 three times. So then what's left would be 3 times the fifth root, 125, a squared b, c to the fourth, all over c. So multiply by what you need to get those exponents equal to the index, and then you can eliminate the radical that way. The final fraction is equivalent to the original with no radical in the denominator.